This is Ken from All Chicago. In this video, I'm going to go through a couple changes that we've made to the matching request form and then the rematch request form that is going live on October 2nd, 2017. So if you're watching this video after that date, please follow these steps to request a match and a rematch. As far as the matching request form goes, the form looks very similar to what you've been using thus far. We've only added two fields, unit detail fields, which we feel will increase the accuracy of your matches. So the first field, you're going to be putting in an email address. This email address will be the one, when you complete this form, the email address will receive a copy of the form of your answers. Moving down, you'll select your agency name and project name from the drop-down boxes, and then you'll indicate who the project contact person is. This is the person who will be contacted when a match is made. You'll indicate the type of housing program, and then we get to the unit detail questions. The first question is this request for a HOPWA-funded unit? And this is a required question. You'll simply select yes or no. The next question is about the unit size. If there's no particular unit size, you can select scattered site individual or scattered site family from the options. With the addition of these questions, you'll no longer be able to lump all of your requests into one. For example, you can no longer select or request matches for HOPWA-funded and non-HOPWA-funded units at the same time. You'll have to submit multiple requests. Even though this is an additional step, we think that the accuracy of your matches will increase because of these two questions. Moving down, nothing else has changed. You're still indicating the number of openings based on the criteria that you provided above, and then the dates of the openings. And we're still keeping the "is there any additional information we need to know" box in case there's anything else you feel that should be provided. Moving to the rematch request form, you'll notice that it looks very similar at the top to the initial request form. You'll indicate the email address where the copy will be sent, indicate your agency and project names, the project contact person, and the type of housing program. Then when we get down here, you're going to be indicating the date of the opening. You are only able to request a rematch for one client at a time. So each time you submit this form, it will be for another opening. You can only request rematches one at a time. And so for the date of opening, we're asking that you put in the previously reported date for this opening, the one that you filled out on the initial match request. We're asking again for the unit details, so select the size of the unit. And then you're going to be inputting the HMIS ID for the client for the initial match. This is the match that you received and didn't work out for whatever reason. You're going to be inputting the HMIS ID here. This will allow us to better track who's getting rematched, and then also why people are not being matched, or why people are ineligible or are declining. Under here, you're going to put the need status of the referral. We're hoping that this is a reminder for you to update the need status in HMIS, just because we're no longer using these need statuses specifically as an indicator that you need a rematch. That doesn't remove the requirement that updating a need status is required for housing providers. And so this need status should match the need status in HMIS. If you've selected that the person was not eligible, we're requiring that you tell us why. And so you could select from any of these. If you did not select that the person was not eligible, you can go ahead and select not applicable. And if the reason is not listed here, you can select other and input an answer here. If the person or family declined to participate, then you can go ahead and select why. And again, if it was not because the person declined, if you need a rematch and it was not because they declined, you can go ahead and select not applicable. And then you'll find the other unit detail question, is this request for a HOPPLE funded unit, at the bottom. And the blank box for you to input any other additional information is there as well. I hope this has been helpful. You'll find the links to the initial match request form and the rematch request form in the description below. Let us know how it's working out for you. Thanks a lot.